our service of worship for this Wednesday, September 23rd, 2020. My name is Mary Kelly, and I am here with my good friend Andrew Van Varick on organ and Jim Bardsley on trumpet. We're coming to you today from the sanctuary of Central Park United Methodist Church in the city of Buffalo. We begin, as always, with a call to praise and prayer. Fires are burning in the American West. In California, Oregon, and Washington State, hundreds of thousands of acres of forested lands have been destroyed. Dozens of our fellow human beings are dead. And thousands more are forced to begin again, their homes and businesses now heaps of ash. While in the Gulf Coast states, Hurricane Sally's storm surge brought devastating floods. In all too familiar occurrences, Mother Earth cries out for climate justice. Human beings have done great harm to our planet, God's wondrous creation. As we gather today, let us remember all of those who are suffering as a result of natural disasters. And may we also repent of the role that we have played in ignoring this ongoing crisis. Let us pray these words of prayer from our brothers and sisters who are native to this country. O Great Spirit, whose breath gives life to the world and whose voice is heard in the soft breeze, we need your strength and wisdom. Cause us to walk in beauty. Give us eyes ever to behold the red and purple sunset. Make us wise, so that we may understand what you have taught us. Help us learn the lessons you have hidden in every leaf and rock. Make us always ready to come to you with clean hands and steady eyes, so when life fades like the fading sunset, our spirits may come to you without shame.
Thank you.
verses 1 through 31. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was without shape or form. It was dark over the deep sea, and God's wind swept over the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And so light appeared. God saw how good the light was. God separated the light from the darkness, and God named the light day and the darkness night. There was evening and there was morning, the first day. God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate the waters from each other." God made the dome and separated the waters under the dome from the waters over the dome. And it happened in that way. And God named the dome sky. There was evening and there was morning, the second day. God said, "Let the waters under the sky come together into one place so that the dry land can appear." And that's what happened. God named the dry land earth, and he named the gathered waters sea. God saw how good it was. And God said, "Let the earth grow plant life, plants yielding seeds and fruit trees bearing fruit with seeds inside it, each according to its kind throughout the earth." And that's what happened. The earth produced plant life, plants yielding seeds each according to its kind, and trees bearing fruits with seeds inside it, each according to its kind. God saw how good it was. There was evening and there was morning, the third day. God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. They will mark events, sacred seasons, days and years. They will be lights in the dome of the sky to shine on the earth." And that's what happened. God made the stars and two great lights, the larger light to rule over the day and the smaller light to rule over the night. God put them in the dome of the sky to shine on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. There was evening and there was morning, the fourth day. God said, "Let the waters swarm with living things, and let birds fly above the earth up into the dome of the sky." God created the great sea animals and all the tiny living things that swarm in the waters, each according to its kind, and all the winged birds, each according to its kind. God saw how good it was. Then God blessed them. "Be fertile and multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." There was evening and there was morning, the fifth day. God said, "Let the earth produce every kind of living thing, livestock, crawling things, wildlife." And that's what happened. God made every kind of wildlife, every kind of livestock, every kind of creature that crawls on the ground. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make humanity in our image to resemble us, so that they may take charge of the fish of the sea, the birds in the sky, the livestock, all the earth, and all the crawling things on earth." And God created humanity in God's image. In the divine image, God created them. male and female, God created them. God blessed them and said to them, be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and master it. Take charge of the fish of the sea, the birds of the sky, and everything crawling on the ground. Then God said, I now give to you all of the plants on the earth that yield seeds, and all the trees whose fruit produces its seed within it. These will be your food. To all wildlife, to all the birds in the sky, and to everything crawling on the ground, to everything that breathes, I give all of the green grasses for food. And that's what happened. God saw everything that God had made. It was supremely good. and brings forth various fruits and flowers of many colors and grass. For all those who pardon one another for your love's sake, and who bear weakness and tribulation, blessed are they who peaceably shall endure, walking by your most holy will. For you, O Most High, shall give them a crown. Praise and bless the Lord, and give thanks unto God, and serve God with great humility. Amen. And now, brothers and sisters, join me in your hearts by praying along with me the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Dear friends, as we leave one another this day, go into the world in peace, blessing all that you